وبركاته.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، جل عن الشبيه والمثيل والنط والكفر والنظير، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله، وصفيه وخليله، وخيرته من خلقه، وأمينه على وحيه، أرسله ربه رحمةً للعالمين، وحجةً على العباد أجمعين، فهدى الله تعالى به من الضلالة، وبصَّر به من الجهالة، وكثَّر به بعد القلة، فصلوات الله وسلامه عليه، وعلى آله وأصحابه، وعلى سائر من اقتفى أثره واتبع منهجه بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، وسلم تسليما كثيرا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته، ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة، وخلق منها زوجها، وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا، يُصلِح لكم أعمالَكم، ويغفِر لكم ذنوبَكم، ومن يُطِعِ الله ورسولَه فقد فازَ فوزًا عظيمًا. ثم أما بعد، فإن أصدقَ الحديث كتاب الله، وخيرَ الهُدى هُدى محمدٍ صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشرَّ الأمور مُحدثاتُها، وكل مُحدثةٍ بدعة، وكل بدعةٍ ضلالة، وكل ضلالةٍ في النار. ثم أما بعد، فاتقوا الله عباد الله، وهي وصيةٌ من الله للأولين والآخرين، ولقد وصَّينا الذين أوتوا الكتاب من قبلكم وإياكم أن اتقوا الله. Dear Muslims, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who gathered us all here in this blessed day, in this blessed month, that he gather us all يوم القيامة with سيد المرسلين محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. آمين يا رب العالمين. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect and save all these beautiful faces from the hellfire. Ameen ya rabbal alameen. Dear Muslims, one time Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when addressing his sahaba, he was giving khutbah on his minbar and he said, يَدْخُلُ عَلَيْكُمْ مِنْ هَذَا الْفَجْرِ أي مِنْ هَذَا الْبَابِ رَجُلٌ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْمَدِينَةِ خَيْرِ ذِي رَجُلٌ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْمَدِينَةِ يعني من أكابر أهل المدينة. From that door, he pointed at the door of the masjid, he said, from that door will men enter from one of the generous, most generous, and one of the greatest men of Yemen. And that was Abdullah al-Bajali radiallahu anhu. He was coming to the Medina to accept Islam. So Rasulullah sallallahu, before he came, he was praising him. He was saying good things about him. And the moment the man entered, all the companions looked at him. And he was surprised why they were looking at me. And then he asked, why you guys looked at me? And then they informed that Rasulullah was saying good things about you, and the man cried. So after Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam finished his speech, he went his home and sat down. Everybody, all the companion, went and sat closer to the possible to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's how the companion used to be with Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, always close as possible with him. So that man didn't find any space for him to sit. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam took his garment, his clothes off, because where the man was standing, there was no any clean place for him to sit. So he took his clothes off and gave to the man and said, sit on it. Imagine, Khairul Bashar, the best man that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created, the most beloved messenger of sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that taking off his garment and giving it to the man to sit on it. So the man, what will happen to the man? Immediately start crying. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said the statement to the companion. He says, إِذَا أَتَاكُمْ كَرِيمُ قَوْمٍ فَأَكْرِمُوهُ. Whenever an honorable person from his place, that he's honorable in his place, in his country, in his village, when he comes to you, you should honor that person. You should respect that person. إِذَا أَتَاكُمْ كَرِيمُ قَوْمٍ فَأَكْرِمُوهُ. Whenever an honorable person comes to you, you should honor that person. You should give some respect to that person. The guest we have among us, with us, this guest is not from any country or from any village or from anywhere. It's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كَفَاهُ شَرَفًا أَنَّ اللَّهَ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى أَنزَلَ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ بَلْ كَفَاهُ شَرَفًا أَنَّ اللَّهَ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى جَعَلَ فِي هَذَا الشَّهْرِ لَيْلَ خَيْرٌ مِّنْ أَلْفِ شَهْرٍ. Is it enough honor that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to this month that he revealed the Qur'an? شَهْرُ رَمَضَانَ الَّذِي أُنزِلَ فِيهِ الْقُرْآنَ. So this guest is not from any country, it's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave honor to this man and revealed the Qur'an. And also in this month, there is a night, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, خَيْرٌ مِّنْ أَلْفِ شَهْرٍ. This night is better than 1,000 months. كَفَاهُ شَرَفًا. It's enough honor that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave this month. So before we enter to any month or anywhere, or let's say you want to do any business, you have to make sure you find out what are you entering with. What are you getting into it? So you have to make sure you investigate, you find out about it. And our Prophet ﷺ and also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, what is this month about? So how are we treating this month? How are we honoring this month? So far, almost 1 week is gone already. The one who gave us this month also said, أَيَّامًا مَعْبُدُودَاتِ. It's just number of days. It's gonna go very fast. So how are we honoring this month? Are we honoring it just decorating our house, decorating our, sufra with the different meals, or are we honoring this month by worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed us, what is this month about? We as human beings, we don't
make any place or any month or anything that Mubarak, except if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam can inform us and tell us what is Mubarak, what place can be Mubarak, what month is Mubarak. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when month of Ramadan arrives, he informs the companion. He tells the companion, Atakum shahru Ramadan. The month of Ramadan has come. Month of Ramadan has arrived. Shahrul Mubarak. This month is blessed month. Mubarak, Shahrul Mubarak. So everything in this month is blessed. And then he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made fard upon you to fast in this month. And then also sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, different narration, different wording, I'm just summarizing it. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when this month arrives, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open up the door of the heaven. This is also an honor for this month. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open up all the door of Jannah and closes the door of the hellfire. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also ties up all the shayateen. So this is our chance to save ourselves from the hellfire and enter to the Jannah. And then in a different narration, Rasulullah ﷺ ended the hadith by saying, the moment that man enters, there is a caller calls out and says, Ya baghi al-khayri aqbil, wa ya baghi al-sharri aqsir. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ended by saying, a caller will call out. So the moment that Ramadan enters, a caller calls out and says, Ya baghi al-khayri aqbil, O seeker of good, proceed and come forward and do good. O seeker of evil, stop, refrain yourself doing evil. So this is our topic, inshallah, for this khutbah. What are the khair we can do in this month, the remaining of this month, and what are the evil we can stop from it? So Rasulullah ﷺ said, the caller calls out and says, Ya baghi al-khayri aqbil, O seeker of good, O a person who does good and wants to do good, come forward, proceed forward and do good as much as you can. What good can we do? Many people, they say, Ya Shaykh, there is nothing change in Ramadan because I'm already out of Ramadan doing khair. I'm already fasting Ayyam al-Bid, Mondays and Thursdays. I'm already praying Qiyamul Layl. What can I do in Ramadan? I don't see any difference. There is always you can improve, always you can do something khair in this month. Why? Because the khairul bashar, asdaqul qailin, he also in Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu mentioned about him, he was the most generous person. Rasulullah ﷺ was most generous out of Ramadan. كان أجود الناس. But when Ramadan comes, أجود ما يكون في رمضان. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu said, and others, that when Ramadan comes, he becomes more generous in this month. More generous in ibadah, more generous worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. On top of that, also when the last 10 night inserts, Aisha radiallahu anha mentioned, أحيا ليلة وأيقظ أهله وشد مئزرة. When the last 10 nights of Ramadan enter, he becomes even more serious, more generous in this month. So we can always find something we can add to it. So don't be a same person in this month that you are out of Ramadan or last Ramadan. Try to improve something. Try to do something in this Ramadan. Try to find something that you can improve yourself. Improve your relationship with your parents. Improve your relationship with your spouse. Improve your relationship with community. Always find something to improve yourself, because that's how Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was. Number one, what can you do in this remaining months? As we know, this is the month of Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed in this month Quran. So the one of the best way to honor this month is to increase in recitation of the Quran. Make a special connection with the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Increase on reading the Quran. If you are reading Quran out of Ramadan, let's say half juz in month of Ramadan, make it into one juz or one and a half juz. Make a special time for Quran. Recite the Quran and also recite it with the translation. Increase on recitation, because Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is mentioned in Hadith Bukhari that every night he meets angel Jibreel alayhi salam and recite Quran, revise Quran with him. And that's Rasulullah says, every night Jibreel comes down and he recites with them. And also some of the Salaf, it mentioned, they used to finish Quran every 2 days. That's how the relationship was with the Quran. One time, Ubay ibn Ka'b was sitting down and he heard a knock in the door. And then he opened the door, he saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he was very excited. Ya Rasulullah, what can I do for you? Please come in. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I came Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala informed me and ordered me to recite Quran to you. He immediately struck crying, saying, Ya Rasulullah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned my name. He said, yeah. He ordered me to recite Quran, Surah Al-Bayyinah to you. Was Ubay ibn Ka'b as a rich man? Was he a king of any country? Was he somebody like so like big? That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned his name? No, because his relationship with the Quran. And Rasulullah also mentioned, take Quran from four, and one of them was Ubay ibn Ka'b. That's how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala elevates the Quran. And Quran is Mubarak, a book of Mubarak. Anything Quran touches becomes Mubarak, and became Mubarak also. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Quran in month of Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rasulullah called this month is Mubarak, month of Mubarak, Shahrul Mubarak. Because Quran is Mubarak also. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Kitabun anzalnahu ilayka mubarakun liyadabbaru ayati. The Quran revealed in Mecca, in the city of Mecca, became the most blessed city on the earth. Place of Mubarak. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, Inna awwala baytin wudi'a lin-nasi lalladhi bibakkata mubarak wa hudan lil'alamin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Quran in Laylatul Qadr, that night also became Mubarak. Inna anzalnahu fi Laylatin Mubarak. So anything Quran touches, because Quran is a full of blessing, full of Mubarak. You want barakah in your life, you want barakah in your family, in your wealth, in your sustaining, connect yourself with the Quran. There are two places Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the word thaqila, the word heavy. Once in Surah Muzzammil and once end of Surah Al-Insan. Word thaqila, word very heavy. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when addressing Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, Inna sanulqi alayka qawlan thaqila. Indeed, we'll be revealing to you a very heavy words, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was talking about Yawmul Qiyamah, he says, وَيَذَرُونَ وَرَاءَهُمْ يَوْمًا ثَقِيلًا. So if you want that day, Yawmul Qiyamah, the heavy day, to be easy on you, then connect yourself with the Quran in this dunya. Because Rasulullah says, اقرأوا القرآن فإنه يأتي يوم القيامة شفيعا لأصحابه. Recite the Quran, not just to listen, not just to decorate your masajid or your house with the Quran. That's not what Quran revealed for. Recite the Quran, make your Quran, this Quran, your best partnership, your best friend in this dunya. Yawmul Qiyamah will come to you as a shafa'ah. So increase on reciting the Quran. The second one is make a lot of dua in this month. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala linked the ayah of dua with ayat of Ramadan. He says, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. Whenever, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying to the Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whenever my slave ask you concerning about me, Allah did not said, say to them. You know, every time there's a question came to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for example, وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الرُّوحِ. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah says to him, answer them, قُلْ. The word قُلْ always come. يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الرُّوحِ قُلِ الرُّوحُ مِنْ أَمْرِ رَبِّي. يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ السَّاعَةِ قُلْ إِنَّمَا عِلْمُهَا عِنْدَ رَبِّي. So always Allah said to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, answer them. But when come to the ayah of dua, he says, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي. Allah didn't say, قُلْ فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. Allah himself answering, saying, فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. I am near always. Will be answering your dua. أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِي إِذَا دَعَانِ. The one who frequently makes dua, not when you need something. Always make sure you're making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, especially in this month. Because Rasulullah said, in this month, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala every night set free people from the hellfire. So this is your chance to ask Allah to save your neck from the hellfire. He says, وَذَلِكَ فِي كُلِّ لَيْلَةٍ. Every night, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala set free people from the hellfire. So make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for yourself, for your family, and especially for our brothers and sisters around the world in Gaza, in Palestine. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy on them. So make a lot of dua, especially the dua, the time that dua get accepted. And that is the time of the iftar. Many people get distracted by preparing the food or, you know, doing things, but this is the time your dua get accepted. Make sure you increase in dua. And the third one, there is a long list, I'm going quickly. The third one, make a lot of istighfar to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Especially before Salatul Fajr. After you finish the suhoor, and it's highly recommended to eat suhoor. Rasulullah he said, تَسَحَّرُوا فَإِنَّ فِي السُّحُورِ بَرَكَةً. Eat suhoor, indeed there is barakah in the suhoor. And the suhoor, it's sunnah to delay as much as you can, the last moment. And also from the Sunnah of Rasulullah to eat, break your fast the moment you hear the Adhan, right away. You don't delay. So Rasulullah said, as long as my Ummah are doing that, they will be in a good term. So try to eat suhoor. After you finish suhoor, do istighfar, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised the people who make istighfar during the suhoor time. He says, وَبِالْأَسْحَارِهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ وَبِالْأَسْحَارِهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised them. So make a lot of istighfar to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعد. أما بعد, we mentioned three things to do good in this month. We're gonna mention quickly a few things that we should refrain ourselves. The caller who called and says يا باغي الخير أقبل, and then also says يا باغي الشر أقصر, O seeker of evil. So we found out, we know from this that there are people who does good and there are people who does evil. So يا باغي الشر أقصر, the people who's doing evil, refrain, stop doing the evil. What are the evil you should stop? Number one, wasting your time. Subhanallah, the time is flying really fast, especially this month. Do not waste your time in social media or the things that are not beneficial. Spend your time that will benefit you in dunya and akhirah. So do not waste your time. And the second one, subhanallah, we are refraining from eating halal. For the water is halal, the food is halal, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered us not to eat when we are fasting. But subhanallah, we are not eating the things that are halal, but we are eating the things that are major sin, and that is our brothers and sisters' flesh, by backbiting, by, you know, lying and slandering and saying things that are not true. If you cannot take anything from this khutbah, I would like you to take this one hadith, if you can, in this month, especially in this month of Ramadan, while you are fasting or any time when you are fasting. This hadith in Bukhari, Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu narrated that he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, مَنْ لَمْ يَدَعْ قَوْلَ الزُّورْ وَالْعَمَلَ بِهِ فَلَيْسَ لِلَّهِ حَاجَةً أَنْ يَضَعَ طَعَامَهُ وَشَرَابَهُ. The one who does not stop or refrain or abandon himself with a false speech, with false talk and false witnessing, and also an evil action, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not need you to stay from drink and eating. Well, who are we fasting for? In the ibadah of fasting, especially for fasting, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Hadith Qudsi, As-sawmu li wa ana ajizi bih. The fasting, especially the fasting in the ibadah, is for me, especially, he says. As-sawmu li wa ana ajizi bih. So we are fasting from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself saying, if you don't leave this action, false speech, false talking, and witnessing also, this is what very common. We always so excited to witness and speak things that are not truth. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that the one who does not stop from that, Allah then don't need for you to stay away from drinking and eating. And some scholars, subhanAllah, they went further and said, the one who fall into that, their fasting is not even accepted. Why? Because they have very strong evidence from the Quran. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about in the Quran, about alcohol, about backbiting, about spying, he used the word fajtanibu, the word fajtanibu for major sin. For example, for alcohol, for gambling, he says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِنَّمَا الْخَمْرُ وَالْمَيْسِرُ وَالْأَنصَابُ وَالْأَزْلَامُ رِجِسٌ مِّنْ عَمَلِ الشَّيْطَانِ فَجْتَنِبُوا. He used the word fajtanibu. And then also in Surah Al-Hujurat, he says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اِجْتَنِبُوا كَثِيرًا مِّنَ الظَّنِّ. When it comes to the false speech, the false talks in Surah Hajj, he says, فَجْتَنِبُوا الرِّجِسَ مِنَ الْأَوْثَانِ وَجْتَنِبُوا قَوْلَ الزُّورِ. So that's why some scholars, they said, if you don't stop this action, your fasting is not accepted. But others says, your fasting will be accepted, but you're not going to get the full reward. So make sure, watch out with your tongue. It's very easy to fast from the food. 7 years old, 8 years old can do it. But you also have to make sure you are watching your tongue, what you're saying. There are some Ahlul Salaf, one of them, he says that past 40 years, I haven't said a word that I want to make sure that I have an answer for it when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks me about it. He have answer for it. Every word that you are speaking, that you are uttering, you are be accountable for that. And anything that you say or lie about someone, In the hadith it mentioned you will be placed in the hellfire, in a very bad place in the hellfire, until you prove that word you have said about the about that person. How can you prove yourself when you are in the hellfire what you said? And the Rasulullah also mentioned in the hadith that most people who enter hellfire is because of their tongue. So make sure you are watching out what you're saying, what you're saying about your brothers and sisters. And the last one is that try to also increase, this is the khair you can do, try to increase in your sadaqah, giving sadaqah. Because Rasulullah also was very generous giving sadaqah in this month. I always say, subhanallah, if you had a parents alive, if your parents passed away, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy upon them. If your parents has passed away already, when they were alive in this dunya, the money that you used to spend on them, or if they were in the back home that you used to bring them to America and send them back, that the money that you used to buy ticket and food for them and stuff, when they passed away, don't stop this money. Continue spending on behalf of them. Because when our parents passed away, or anyone passed away, especially our parents, many people think that our birr, our goodness to the parents is ended. No, you can. The actual birr starts after they passed away, after their death. Because now they are died, they are dead now, they cannot do any khair, any a'mal. So they left you behind so you can do that for them. So continue spending that money that you used to spend for them in this dunya on behalf of them. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you and them inshallah. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وأذل الشرك والمشركين ودمر أعداءك أعداء الدين اللهم تقبل صيامنا اللهم تقبل صيامنا وقيامنا وركوعنا وسجودنا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم اعتق رقابنا من النار ورقاب آبائنا وأمهاتنا وجميعا من النار برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم أصلح أحوال المسلمين في كل مكان اللهم أصلح أحوال المسلمين في كل مكان برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعيذكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله الجليل يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون